Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters, I want to bring a very important lesson to each and every one of us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, and this is in Surah Nuh, where Nuh alayhi salam is communicating with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he's telling him that, you know, he's telling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he would call the people towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he would tell them, فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ. You know, he told the people, seek forgiveness of your Lord, your Creator, right? إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. He is the one who is forgiving. يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا. And so when you seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sends upon you, or He gifts you with certain things. And then Nuh alayhi salam mentions five things. But one thing that I really want to focus on in this, in these verses, is where Nuh alayhi salam says, يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ. So he tells the people, or he told his people, and this is a lesson for us as well, the more istighfar, the more forgiveness you seek from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he grants you with rain that is beneficial, right? Something that is beneficial for the lands and the crop and so on and so forth. He also benefits us with money, mal, right? Wealth, things that are good for us in this life, wealth, whether it's land or property or a house or a car, any type of wealth. And then Nuh alayhi salam teaches us a beautiful lesson, and this is the lesson for those who have a difficult time, for example, as a couple, you know, maybe not being able to have children. Continue to make istighfar, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially if you're a newlywed couple and you're trying to have children, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through your seeking of forgiveness, will bless you with children. يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us children from istighfar. And that is something absolutely beautiful, brothers and sisters. Don't ever feel as though you can't be rewarded from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't feel as though it's a punishment upon you. And even if you continue to make istighfar and you don't have children, Alhamdulillah, khair. That is good for you. That is what is best for you. You know, I know someone, in fact, I know many people, but I know one couple in particular, a couple that I know really well who lives in Malaysia. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed them with many things, but He also blessed them with with not having children, right? And the reason why I say it's a blessing for them is because this couple, right, uses their wealth in ways where they can help others, and they use their time in ways that they can help others. And so I feel sometimes that if they were to have children, they wouldn't be able to benefit so many hundreds of, or maybe even thousands of people that are around them with the time and the wealth that they have, that they devote towards helping others. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gifted them with that. And so not having children is not a punishment from Allah. In fact, it could be a blessing in disguise, a blessing that we're not really aware of, if only we were to look at it from a different angle. Jazakumullahu khairan, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.